QR codes are incredibly amazing in iOS apps due to their versatility and convenience. With just a quick scan using the device's camera, users can unlock a multitude of functionalities seamlessly. Whether it's accessing a website, making payments, sharing contact information, or even joining Wi-Fi networks, QR codes simplify tasks that would otherwise require manual input or navigation through various menus. In an iOS app, integrating QR code capabilities enhances user experience by streamlining processes and reducing friction, ultimately saving time and effort for both developers and users alike. So, let's learn how to add one to your app today. And if you want to learn more about Swift and SwiftUI and iOS development, go ahead and check out Rebeloper.com/mentoring. More on that later in the video. Now, today we are going to learn how to add a QR code into your iOS application. And we are going to use this really, really helpful, nice library from DagRomph. It's called QR code. It's at github.com/DagRomph/QR code. Now, I have just opened up a brand new Xcode project, as you can see right over here. Let's relaunch the preview right over here. And we want to actually just add our site, rebeloper.com/mentoring, into the QR code. Now, as you can see here, I just have simply my image of logo that is in the assets. I already added it there, just so you know. And we are going to add that to our QR code too. So, how would we start off right over here? Well, we want to add, first of all, our GitHub repository right over here. So let's just copy that out. Let's come back and select your project, package dependencies, click on the plus button over there, and just add that under the search, and it will just pop up just like that. Currently, in this tutorial, we are using 18.3.0. Let's add that as a package. And then let's just choose this one only. You know, if you want to add more options, then you can do so. Let's add that package right over there. And this is going to add all of these dependencies. Okay, so now we can come back to our content view. Let's wait for that preview to refresh and let's start building this up. Well, first of all, we actually need some sort of image that we are going to represent right over here. And we are going to need a CG image for that. So let's create a state variable for that. State private var image of type CG image. Okay, and if that image is not nil, we are going to present it. Otherwise, we are not going to present it. So let's remove this default views right over here. So and we say if let image, then we are going to say image, and we are going to use the one with the UI image. And with the UI image, we are going to use the one with the CG image. So this is how we are just going to port from CG image to an actual Swift UI image. Okay, let's just pass that along right over there. Let's make this resizable and let's set a frame width. Let's just say 300. And the height of 300. Of course, now we are not going to see anything because the image is still nil. And also, maybe let's just have a padding right over here just to make sure. Okay.
Are you an aspiring iOS developer? Collaborating with me as your mentor at rebeloper.com/mentoring can accelerate your career. With substantial industry expertise and a comprehensive grasp of iOS development, I provide actionable advice, insights into industry trends, and effective coding techniques to support your success. Let's advance your iOS journey together. Connect with me at rebeloper.com/mentor.
So now we want to incorporate that URL into our QR code. That I'm just going to do on the on-appear, but basically you can just do anywhere you want to. And I don't really like the auto-completion from Xcode, so I'm just going to do it like that. Okay, so first we need to import our QR code. So import QR code. And let's just talk a little bit about how this will be made up. Well, basically, we are going to add a string. We are going to encode a string. That's one thing. Then we are going to set up the eyes. And then we are going to set up the pixel types. So if you take a look at, let me just go back to our Safari. You will see, let's just scroll down. There are a tremendous ways of customizing all of this. See, these are the eyes right over here. These three that, you know, just make sure that when you are scanning your QR code, it's, you know, scanning the right thing. And then these are the pixels, of course, that you are going to scan. And there are tremendous ways of customizing this. So, for example, here's the usage. And let me just scroll a little bit down on the design part. Here are the eye shapes. So we have square, circle, round rect, and so forth. So leaf, all of that good stuff. So a tremendous way of customizing the eye. Also, you can customize the pupil inside the eye. So again, all of those are in there. And finally, we can customize the pixels. This is really, really nice. We are going to use the rounded rect in, if I remember correctly. But yeah, you can just choose any of these. And here are some nice examples of what you can achieve. And finally, what we are going to do, it's right over here, we are going to add our logo. That's why I have my logo preset inside the assets folder, because we are going to add some logo. If you want to take a look at where to add it, you can do so also on the README right over here. So let's come back to our Xcode project and let's just start typing out some stuff, because, you know, it's really, really easy to do so. So we imported QR code. That's one step. Now we need to create a document. So doc, let doc equals QR code, QR code dot document. And we want to use the one with the UTF-8 string. Okay. And maybe the error correction, let me just talk about that too. So error correction. So UTF string, we are going to add HTTPS, rebeloper.com/mentoring. There we go. Make sure that you also add HTTPS in there, because otherwise it will not recognize it as, you know, a valid URL. And then we have this error correction. If you just tap on dot right over here, you will see that we have, let's just go with high, but there are high, low, medium. So error correction, what does that mean? Well, we are going to actually add also an image to it, and how high the probability would be that, I know, maybe this is printed out and it's smudged and all of that stuff, how much the error correction, the probability of that would be to actually decode that string that you have added right over here. So I would just go with high, but, you know, it depends on your situation. Okay, so let's design the shape of the eye. So let's have a doc dot and then design dot shape dot eye. And as you can see, this is like with the dot notation. I really like that you can just have all of this. It's really typo proof. And then we are just going to add an eye design shape. So we just go QR code dot eye shape dot, and you can just have here all of these. Let's just go for maybe rounded a point pointing in. Yeah, that's what I chose for my example, but you can just choose any of the available ones. Okay, then we are, well, actually, let's just see some stuff over here. So now we are going to add this to our image. So self.image equals doc.cg image. And you can see we want to provide a size, and that will be a CG size with a width and height. For the width, you don't have to do it with 300 by 300. Let's just have 800, for example, by 800. Okay, let's see that. And there we go. Now, let me just remove the eye shape so you can see the difference. You see, this is just a random generated usual QR code. Added the eye shape. It's much, much nicer. Okay, so now that we had the eye shape, let's talk about the actual pixels, because, you know, these are, again, squared. Let's just customize them even further. Let's have a doc dot design dot shape dot on pixels, and that will be QR code again, QR code dot pixel shape dot. And now you can just have again all of these. Let's just type out horizontal, and you may, if you just add in horizontal right over here, it's not going to add any changes. You want to set also the inset fraction and the corner radius fraction. So let's hit option, then select return. And for that, I just found 0.1 and 1 to be better. So now you can see that it's really, really nice. Now it's taking a really, really becoming really custom. Okay, and finally, let's add our logo to it. So first of all, we want to make sure that there is an image in our asset catalog. So we're just going to guard against that. Guard let logo image equals UI image. Named and mine is named logo, and we are going to extract its CG image, else we are going to return. There we go. Let me just move this a little bit further and up so we can see the code better. Nice. Okay, so now that we have our CG image, we want to incorporate it. So let me just have a new line over there. We are going to go again, doc.logoTemplate equals QRCode.logoTemplate. And we are going to use the one with the image and the path. There we go. So the image, here we have our CG image. So that will be a logo image. And the path basically is where we want to put this image on the QR code. So let's have a CG rect over here. So CG path, first of all, CG path with a rect of CG rect. And let's just choose the one X, Y, width and height right over there. Before we set up our rect, I'm just going to set the transform to nil. We don't need that. And let's just talk about this CG rect. So X and Y is basically where you want to put it inside this square of the QR code. And width and height is actually the size of it. So I'm just going to go with 0.35 and 0.35 because that's kind of in the middle, and for the width and height 0.30 and 0.3 again. Okay, so now you can see it's right in center. Yeah, if you want to put it maybe at the corner, just play around with this CG rect right over there. And now that's it. If we want to, let me just go ahead and scan that. And it says already rebeloper.com. So I'm just going to tap on it. And let's see if it's just going to go to the mentoring. And yes, indeed, it is going to the mentoring. So it's as simple as that. Again, the library is github.com/dagronf QR code. Go ahead and check it out, and There's a ton of customization. And if you'd like to learn more about Swift and SwiftUI, go ahead and check out developer.com/mentoring.